What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So, I've been waiting to do this for quite a while. I'm pretty excited for what we have in this video. I actually am doing the intro after we're done. But, yeah, hope you guys enjoy this video. We're putting the 7.3 Powerstroke aluminum intercooler in my truck. So, yeah, enjoy the video. There's a whole lot of crap down in there. Yeah, you can see it in there. Yeah. So it'll have a whole lot more airflow, right?
Oh, yes.
All of the airflow. Let's see.
Dude, that's going to make so much difference. Maybe we need a cleaner.
Okay, so we got a whole lot done here. You can see I had to grind out right there. And then a little bit up on the inside too. You can't really see it from this angle. I had to build us some brackets for the bottom here. And then for the top, we had to cut the top bracket off just a little bit. But over here, we're gonna have to shorten the hood latch just a little bit, it looks like. I don't really want to mash the top of my intercooler down, but if we have to do that just a little bit, that'll be fine. Here you can see the other side. I had to kind of clean it up. Had to cut all the old mounts. Let me pull this out of the way. Cut all the old mounts for the old one off. So, yeah, we're coming along pretty nicely here. And this eBay special is working out so far. I have to put it to the test with like 70 pounds of boost, but working out there, you can see how I had to trim the inside right there. There's the other side. I had to clean it up a little bit more. It's not completely as nice as I would like it to be. So, yeah, and then we're getting, Jay has the plate off right now, intake plate off to get that machined out for our 6-7 intake horn. So guys, unfortunately my camera battery died and I did not have the charger with me or the spare battery. I forgot it and left it at home. So the last clip you saw was Jay was starting to tack up some of the brackets. I got pictures of everything. I should have got a few videos on my phone. But I got pictures, so I'll throw them in here right now so you can see like the brackets, how we did with the top and everything, because now we have it together and it's kind of hard to see that. So I'm going to throw that in right here. Okay guys, so we had a few different things that turned out a little different than I was hoping. We were not able to use our 6-7 intake. We had to use a 5-9 common rail intake. And also, these are 5-9 common rail intercooler pipes too. We just had to trim this one. We had to trim, you can kind of see it down in there, we had to trim the ends off of it and roll new beads on both ends. This one we only had to cut the one end off just a couple inches and roll a new bead. As far as the intake, it's just a 45 degree pipe with the air filter I had laying around the shop. As far as EGTs go, this thing, the best I've seen is just getting into it up until it's at full boost and letting out. I just got 52 pounds of boost at 1100 EGTs. I can keep in it and it'll get up to, eventually it'll hit 1400 EGTs, but I'm really happy. I can't get it over 1400 EGTs. By the time you're that high EGTs, you're probably, I don't know, 9500 mile an hour, I want to say. So yeah, there's a lot more room for a lot more fuel once we get a bigger turbo on this thing, or turbos. So yeah, this was turned out very nice. Cruising down the road, 100 EGTs less, I'm seeing about 600 EGT, 650 cruising. I mean, now you hit some hills, you'll see 750 depending on the size of the hill. But yeah, it's definitely quite a bit cooler. On the top end, it's definitely cooler. You can tell it's flowing a lot more air. You probably seen my video on Instagram if you're following me, of the turbo was like barking on spool up. Basically, that is too much restriction between here and the head. So that opened it up a lot more. Also, the other thing was too small of a turbine wheel, because this is a 62 billet compressor and a 65 turbine. Also, very, very small AR compressor cover, just because it's the S300G, which is basically a small frame S300 turbo. So once we go to a regular S300 turbo on the manifold, that should go away completely. We could get rid of that by going with smaller injectors, but there's no reason to go with less fuel. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. I hope you can hear me, by the way. It's really raining. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, make sure to drop them in the comments. Send me a message on Instagram. I'll put my Instagram right here on the screen. Make sure to go follow me if you're not following me already.